Customizable input mappings. You know them, you love them, and they're a crucial part of any PC game. Whether indie or AAA, every PC game needs and should have an input mapping menu. And you're in luck. I'm here to guide you step by step on how to create a fully functional and customizable input mapping system and menu for your Unreal Engine 5 game. First, you need to set up our mappings to be player mappable. To do that, we will go to our mapping context. For the third person template, you can find it in third person, then input, and you want to open IMC default. For the other templates, it would just be in that folder instead. Now in IMC default, you want to press the triangle to open up the jump and move actions, and for spacebar, W, A, S, and D, you want to open them up and check the box next to is player mappable. Then under player mappable options, next to name, you want to type a name for each button, something like jump, forward, left, right, and back. Then you can save. Feeling stuck or overwhelmed? Check out my new website, www.savagedevs.com. It's packed with step-by-step written guides that complement these tutorials. Plus, you can join our free developer forum to get all of your questions answered. Just click the link in the description to sign up for free at www.savagedevs.com and level up your game development skills. Now let's get back to the video. Now you can go back to the content browser, and in the content folder, you want to make a new folder and call it UI. Then in that folder, you want to right-click and under User Interface, select Widget Blueprint, and in the pop-up, just select the first option and name it Map Key. Then make a copy and call it Map Key List. Then open Map Key List. Now in the widget, we want to add a canvas panel, then add a scroll box, and set the alignment to 0.5 by 0.5, then change the anchors to center with position 0x, 0y, then set the size to 1500x, 800y. Then you can save the widget and go to your character blueprint. Now in the character blueprint, you want to add a key event for the key you want to use for the menu. I will use the I key for this guide, as the escape key won't work in the editor. Then, from the pressed event, you want to drag out a flip-flop node. Now from A, you want to drag out a create widget node and set it to the map key list widget. Then from return value, you want to right-click and hit promote to variable and name it. Then from it, drag out an add to viewport node. Then right-click and add a get player controller node, and from the return value, drag out a set show mouse cursor node and set it to true. Next, add a set input game mode and UI node and connect the player controller and set the menu to the in widget to focus pin. Now, for the B of the flip-flop, you want to drag out the variable and right click and select convert to validated get and connect it to the B. Now from is valid, drag out a remove from parent node and connect the target pin. Then copy the set show mouse cursor node and set the value to false. Finally, drag out a set focus to game viewport node and save and compile. Now back in the content browser, we want to open up the map key widget and add a horizontal box widget. Then in that, add a text block and a key selector. Then set them to fill and put a 2 next to the fill on the text box. Next, click the checkbox next to is variable and go to the graph. Next, drag out the text block variable and from it, drag out a set node connected to the event construct event, and for the text, promote that to a variable named text. Then drag out the input key selector variable and use a set selected key node and split the in selected key pin, then promote the pin to a variable. Then make the key and text variables instance editable and expose on spawn, then save and compile. Now we need to go back to the map key list, and in the graph, we want to make a custom event called refresh mappings. Next, we want to make a new input of type enhanced action key mapping, then name it key map and make it an array. Next, from the event, drag out a for each loop node and connect the array and split the output pin twice. Next, drag out a create widget node set to our map key widget. For text, use the display name pin. And for key, use the array element key pin from the for each loop. Next, make the scroll box a variable and go back to the graph, then drag out the scroll box and from it take out an add child node and connect it to the return value of the widget. Then you can compile and save and go back to the character. Now in the character, you want to find the begin play event and you want to find the enhanced input player local subsystem. And from it, you want to drag out a get all player mappable action key mappings node and promote it to a variable called mapping and connect it. Now we can drag out the map key list variable for the widget and from it drag out a refresh mappings node. Then you can connect it up and make sure to check that the map key list is valid first. Then to make sure that the mapping context is valid, we need to wait a bit after adding the mapping context. To do this, we will get the length of our get all player mappable action key mappings node. We will then get a branch node to check if there are any elements. Next, connect the true to the set node and connect the false to a delay until next tick node connected back to the branch in a loop. Now back at where we make the UI, we will also add a refresh mapping node and connect it to our variable. Then we can save and compile and go to the map to test our UI. Right now, when we change the values, nothing happens as we have not made the setting code yet. So we can go back to our player character to fix this. Now we make a custom event called update mappings. And we will give it an input called display name set to text. Then we need to copy the code for the player subsystem and hook it up. Next, drag out an add player map key node and use the display name as the mapping name input by converting the text to a string, then the string to a name. Then for new key, drag it to the event to make an input. Now back in our map key graph, we want to go to the variable for the key selector. And in the details, we want to press the plus icon next to on key selected to add the event. Then we can get the player character and cast to your player. Next, as our player, drag out an update mappings a node, and for display name use the text variable, and for new key split the selected key pin and use the selected key pin. Then you can save and compile. Now back in the map, if you press play and press I, you can change the mapping values and they will reflect in the game. Right now, if you close and reopen the game, these values are not saved, but this video has gone on long enough, so you'll have to wait for the next video where I'll set up the saving system for these values. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, a subscription is a free way to say thanks, and don't forget to hit that bell to be notified of the next video where we will be setting up the saving system for the inputs. If you have any questions or concerns, you can now leave them in my new website at www.savagedevs.com. You can also look over this guide in written form on my website if it would help you. If you want to add on to your own settings menu, why not watch this video here? Until next time, have a great day and bye for now.